This part, Mary's going to show us how to make a Simnel cake. And traditionally, this was the cake that was made for Mothering Sunday, which is the fourth in Lent. And it's now, though, become the traditional fare for Easter time as well, hasn't it, Mary? What makes it different from an ordinary rich fruit cake?
The difference is, Judith, that it has a layer of almond paste in the middle. So you bake it, you first of all make a fairly ordinary fruit cake, and then you put half the mixture in the tin, then a layer of almond paste, and then a layer of the cake mixture, so that you actually bake the almond paste in the middle, and it is delicious. Don't only have it for Easter, it's nice to perhaps make it in a loaf shape for all year round.
Looks pretty when it's decorated there too. That's the finished product, isn't it?
That's the finished product,
yes.
And I think it's so different, and it's very nice to have at Easter. Mm. The cake that I'm going to make now is a very quick recipe. It's all in the bowl mixture, because I think we'll all be jolly busy at Easter time, and you don't perhaps want to be beating endlessly. So I'm going to make it with using a luxury margarine, and I have 6 ounces of luxury margarine, and it's already soft and easy to cream. Mm. So everything will go in the bowl at once.
You say if people wanted to use butter they could, but it would have to be as soft as that.
You would have to get it really soft, put it in a warm place. Mm. And to that I'm going to add 3 eggs, and they're already broken. 1, 2, 1 more to come. 3. And fruit. 10 ounces of mixed fruit, include some raisins in with the fruit, it'll make it that much better. And 6 ounces of brown sugar. I've used soft brown sugar because it's not so granular. And a little candied peel, 1 ounce, and 2 ounces of cherries, fairly finely chopped. This means they won't sink to the bottom as well. And 2 tablespoonfuls of milk.
That's to just give it that dropping. And
you need just a little bit more milk to make it right. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then the flour and spices. Now I'm going to put that over the top. And it is essential to sieve the flour because you add baking powder to it. In a fruit cake of this time kind, many people use self-raising flour, but I'm using a plain flour with a little extra baking powder. Then this is 6 ounces of plain flour, 1 teaspoonful of baking powder. There we are, 1 teaspoonful of baking powder, and 3 teaspoonfuls of ground mixed spice. If you like, you can add 2 ounces of ground almonds to this recipe. Makes it extra delicious, but they're a little bit expensive at the moment, and I think we've got plenty with the amount we've got. And in with the fruit, I have the grated rind of 1 lemon. This could be an orange if you prefer. So sieve the flour.
Very easy operation, isn't it? I've always thought it was a painstaking one to make a rich fruit cake.
I've got 3 sultanas on the top. With fine, can I give you that?
Thanks. Yep.
Now to the mixing. It just needs beating well. I just bind it to begin with. And it's because of the soft fat, it mixes well. Much easier than the creaming method. And for a fruit cake, I think it is just as good, if not better.
Mm. Apparently, we were saying that these Simnel cakes originally were made by the mistress in these very grand households and given to the servant girls for their one day off in the year, which was Mothering Sunday, the fourth in Lent, to take home to their mothers.
It's a charming idea, isn't it?
Mm.
The thought of having any one day off in the year is a bit hard.
Right, yes.
There we are. Mm. Now, that's, as you were saying, soft dropping.
Mm.
So, I'm going to divide this mixture in half. I'll do it now so I don't forget. There we are. Half to go in the top of the tin and half in after the almond paste. Now this tin, Judith, I've already lined with greaseproof paper.
It looks very neat, I must say, the lining.
Well, I'll show you how I do it. If you get a piece of, there's an awful lot of rustle here. There we are, a piece of greaseproof paper and snip along the bottom having folded it, and then it will slip easily into the tin and round and fit closely, and then a circle of paper in the bottom. So grease the tin, grease the paper.
And what size of tin?
7-inch tin.
Mm.
So that's half the mixture in the tin.
Mm.
Level it. I should be about 2 inches taller to lean over to the front. And then a circle of almond paste. I'm using 1 pound of almond paste for the whole cake. If you only want almond paste in the middle, then you need only have a third the amount. So this is a third of the pound, and just a circle slipped in like that, pressed gently down, and then the rest of the mixture on top. So it's a really easy cake to make.
Here we are. As you say, if you're going to decorate it, you just put the marzipan on the top.
Yes.
Don't you know?
And we'll bake this later, because we've still got the lemon meringue pie in the oven. Mm. And the temperature to bake it is 300 degrees Fahrenheit, gas number 2, for 2.5 hours.
There we are. In the middle of the oven?
Yes, in the middle of the oven.
Okay, thanks.
And to finish the cake, I'm not going to do it completely because won't have time, but there's the cake already baked, and then you put almond paste on top of the cake, having first brushed it, this is the other third, having brushed it with apricot jam, put the circle on top, and then just pinch the edges. Mm. You see, it's what our mothers do around the outside. There we are.
And the final third make the balls, in fact,
that's
don't
right.
they?
Yes. 11 of them.
11, and they represent 11 apostles, because Judas, the traitor, is not represented on the Easter cake.
And then a little bit of runny icing on the top, just water icing coloured green, and you pop the chicken on top. And eggs.
Most attractive. It looks lovely and it smells good. We've had a good sniff at the cake this morning.
Well, it is nice and rich.
Yes.
And it keeps very well.
Does it?
Yes.
Mm. You've got another lovely idea here, which I don't quite know what it's for.
These are crystallised primroses. Primroses, I picked these yesterday, and they're readily available. If you don't want crystallised primroses, you could do violets, any sort of rather soft, delicate plant, flower does well. If you live in London and you can't get in the country, freesias, just two freesias would look very nice on a cake.
Or indeed buy primroses from the florists,
yes.
You can, can't you?
So you brush the primroses with egg white, and this is for crystallising them. Then you just spoon sugar over the top. Don't forget to do the stalk as well. And that's not, you don't dip it straight in,
no.
You just sprinkle it over the top. Then you leave them to dry off in an airing cupboard for 2 days, and they end up like this. These have been in my airing cupboard. Now you feel how crisp. It looks so fragile, doesn't
it? Yes, and very firm and hard, isn't it? You must never dip them right into the white of egg, must you, Mary? Because that would be too soggy, presumably.
It would. Now you see those three finger marks?
Yes.
One small son was nearly crowned yesterday for doing that. So let's cover them up by putting some leaves and some primroses. This is just a plain glacé iced cake. Mm. And you can hear they're crisp as you put them down.
I think they're charming. And they're going to last crisp like that for as long as the cake will, I should think, because the cake will go pretty quickly by the look of it.
Yes.
A couple of days, do you think, Mary?
Yes, it
going
would.
Soggy.
And it's so nice for a little girl's birthday cake too. And it's almost free to do. None of your old expensive crystallised violets from the shop.
Mm.